Kathy Griffin says she can't get work after Trump beheading photo, has to leave U.S. Comedian Kathy Griffin has had a pretty rough year ever since she posed with a fake severed head that looked like President Donald Trump. Griffin initially apologized for the photo, but she has since gone off the rails completely, retracted her apology, and started claiming that she is being unfairly targeted for her actions. On Saturday, Griffin posted her State of the Union video on YouTube, where she rambled on about how she was being blacklisted in Hollywood and whined about being unable to find work. At 57, I don't have a lot of time to be patient. Don't be too hard on me. I'm fully in the middle of a Hollywood blacklist, she said during her rant. I just want you guys to know, when I get home, I do not have one single day of paid work in front of me. Because no one in their right mind wants Griffin to perform in the United States, she's had to leave the country and find work abroad. Doesn't that just break your heart? Imagine that, someone in Hollywood actually has to live with the consequences of what they did. I'm sure that's a novel concept for Griffin. Kathy Griffin says she can't get work after Trump beheading photo. So she can't get work in US. Works for me. Footage from Kathy Griffin's YouTube and Life and Style used here to provide cultural commentary and context for the Kathy Griffin's alleged blacklisting. And people that want me to go back and start in comedy clubs and do 10 minutes again, I don't mean to be an A, but no. I'm not going to do that, she stated. I've worked way too hard to go back and work for free and do the club scene again, cause this is some bull, because I've been blacklisted, Griffin continued. You'd think after her many years in the comedy scene, Griffin would have more than enough money in the bank to keep her going for a long time. Apparently that isn't the case if she is so desperate that she is making YouTube videos complaining about her lack of income. I'm not going to lie. It's going to be hard when I go home and I don't have one show in my future, she claimed. You probably won't find many people who are too upset over the prospect of never having to see a Griffin show ever again. It's not like they were that great in the first place. I think I should be able to get my life back. So, I know I took a picture that offended a lot of people, but this wall of crap has never fallen on any woman in the history of America the way it has on me, she added. Maybe if Griffin had used a few brain cells and thought before she took that photo, she wouldn't be in the situation she is in right now. Actions have consequences, and Griffin is learning that lesson the hard way. If you don't want to be blacklisted, don't offend over half the country. Hopefully Griffin's predicament will serve as a lesson to the rest of Hollywood that doing something stupid is going to cost you dearly.